The capacity is saying how many bits per symbol that we can transmit with arbitrarily low error probability if we send a large sequence of them. And in slow fading, we are getting one realization that is random of the channel, and that one is used throughout this entire sequence. The problem is the transmitter doesn't know what the realization is. If it knew, then we can compute the capacity. We call it CG, it's log 2 of 1 plus Q, then we have absolute value G square divided by N naught for this size of channel that I'm considering to start with. And since the transmitter doesn't know the realization, we assume the receiver knows it, then it needs to guess on what the capacity is going to be. And it selects a rate R, an information rate in bits per symbol as well, and if it happened to be smaller than the realization of this channel capacity, then we have a successful transmission. And if it is larger than the actual capacity of the channel, we have an outage. And that means that we won't be able to communicate. The entire transmission will be failed. Strictly speaking, the capacity is zero in this case, because R equal to zero is the only rate that always leads to a successful communication. However, in order to have a useful system, we need to select an R that's larger than that, and live with that we have a probability of outage, a probability that the transmission is failing. We can define the probability of outage, we call it P out of R, and that's a probability that R is greater than CG for the realization of G that we were getting. And we can compute it exactly, but the important thing is what happens when the SNR is large. Then we get, under Rayleigh fading, approximately 2 to the power of R minus 1 divided by the SNR. So the probability of outage goes down as 1 over the signal-to-noise ratio. We can illustrate the outage probability concept like this. Here's the probability density function of CG, the capacity for realization G, and we see that it varies between 0 and up to 3, 4, 5. And then we select a rate R, and then we see how often is R greater than CG. Well, then we should have the area under the curve for values between 0 and R. So that is what is illustrated by the shaded region here. That area is the outage probability. And the smaller R is, the smaller the outage probability is going to be, but also the lower the information rate is going to be when you are successful. So there is a gamble here between having a high rate, but having also high outage. Having multiple receive antennas is a very effective way of reducing the outage probability in the communication system. So the receiver knows the channel, so it can apply maximum ratio combining. In that way, it achieves the beamforming gain, as we had talked about before, but it also achieves something called a diversity gain. And that means that the variations of the channel around its mean become smaller and smaller. And that's essentially because the risk that multiple antennas, all of them, are experiencing deep fade at the same time becomes smaller and smaller. And we say that we get a diversity gain of order m when we have m receive antennas. That means that the probability of outage goes down as 1 over SNR to the power of m. Here is an illustration of this concept showing the outage probability in logarithmic scale on the vertical axis and the SNR in dB on the horizontal axis. The black solid line is showing what you get with one receive antenna and one transmit antenna. We have a slope of minus 1 because it goes down as the SNR to the power of minus 1. If we go up to 2 receive antennas, we get the red curve which has a better slope. It goes down as minus 2 in this log-log scale. And if we go up to 4 receive antennas, we get a diversity gain of order m, and then the curve goes even steeper down as 1 over SNR to the power of m. So the receive diversity achieved in the SIMA system with m antennas is very effective to reduce the probability of outage in the communication system in Rayleigh fading. If you instead have multiple transmit antennas, can you still achieve the same gains? Well, you can't do the optimal maximum ratio transmission, because that would require you to know the channel. And that was the whole point with the outage concept, that you don't know the channel. Still, there is something called space-time coding, where you transmit the signals in a smart way over time and space. So a block of signals are transmitted over the antennas according to a certain pattern that allow the receiver to pull them apart and achieve a diversity gain. Here is an illustration of the diversity gain you can achieve with multiple transmit antennas. So we have the outage probability on the vertical axis and the SNR in dB scale on the horizontal axis. The black curve is the Zeiser case, and then we get the slope of minus 1. Then if you have the red curve, with space-time coding, we have two antennas, we're using something called the Alamutti code, then you get a diversity gain because it goes down as the SNR to the power of minus 2. The blue curve is the SIMO case, as we described before. It has the same slope, but there's also a 3 decibel improvement going to the left, and that means that we also get the beamforming gain. But we can achieve a diversity gain of order m when we have m transmit antennas, if we're using space-time codes. So in summary, in the slow fading channel where the transmitter doesn't know the channel realization, it has to select an information rate to communicate that. And there is a risk for outage, that you're selecting a rate that is larger than the channel is supporting, but you can use multiple antennas, either at transmitter or at the receiver, or actually on both, even if we didn't talk about that, to reduce the probability of outage, and that is called the diversity gain.